Well, good morning. This is Kim Sturmer. Today is August 20th, 2008, and this is the beginning of an incredible hot springs adventure to Santa Barbara. Right now I'm currently filming on the top of El Camino Cielo. I'm on my way to Big Caliente and Little Caliente hot springs. It's just an absolutely perfect day. It's gorgeous. It's about 7:20 and the sun is out. It's 70 degrees and this is just absolutely the beginning of a wonderful adventure. I've been to Big Caliente many times, as well as I've been to Little Caliente, but it's always a pleasure to come up here and check them out. I called the Forest Service yesterday. Gate should be open up ahead, so looking forward to getting up there and getting in some good soaks. Probably will spend all day here. I'm going to do a little panorama here right now to give you an idea of what the view looks like up here on the top of the bluff. Probably won't do too much more commentary except an occasional one as we progress through the journey. Okay, so that's it for now, and sit back, relax, and enjoy the hot springs. Again, I'm up here on El Camino Cielo, about elevation 4,000 feet behind the mountains, or behind Santa Barbara. This is the trailhead for the Cold Springs Trail leading down into the Santa Ynez River Valley drainage. This trail is about, as it says, Mono Camp, 5 miles. And that's basically how far it is to get to Little Caliente Hot Springs. I've hiked this trail before. It's a very intense, hot, dusty trail, especially for the climb back. You're descending about 2,500 feet and it's quite a climb coming back. But I'm hoping today that the gate is open so I don't have to hike this and I can drive right on down to Little Caliente and Big Caliente. Again, this is the mountains to the east. I'm going to pan around a little bit and give you an idea of what this area looks like. This is just an old lookout of some sort, a water tower or something up on the mountains. And in the distance here you can see Santa Barbara. There's still a lot of low coastal clouds, a lot of fog blanketing. Those are the Channel Islands in the background. I don't know if you can see that That's Santa Cruz Island. And that's about it. So I'm going to keep on journeying down the road here. I'll take a shot as we get further down when the pavement ends and it turns to dirt. Well, here we are at the dirt road, trailhead road that leads down to Big Caliente and Little Caliente. And as it has it, I'm in luck today. The gate is open. There's actually three trails here, three roads. There's a spur going off to the left over here that just goes down a short distance to a parking overlook. And then the trail, the road that goes down to the hot springs is over there where my truck is. You can see that pretty clearly as the road goes down. That gate, last time I was here, that gate was closed because of the fire danger. There's another spur road over here, and this basically leads to an off-road vehicle motorcycle area. It goes along the crest further to the south. So this is awesome. The road that I'll be embarking on is a very precarious dirt road. I've still got approximately 10 to 12 miles to go to the hot springs, and this road in particular is the one where when I was in high school, I came up here with my friend Jim, and we were driving his 64 Dodge Dart, and as we were going down the hill, he was driving, and I was looking at the view, and then all of a sudden, he decided to just jump out of the car, and next thing I know, I turn around, and there's nobody driving this car. It's careening down this precarious road with a 2,000-foot drop on the left, and I fortunately got my left foot, jammed on the brakes, ran it into the hillside, came back, and found Jim, and I said, "Hey, dude, what happened? Why'd you jump out of the car?" He said, "Oh, man, I was just having a bad acid flashback. Didn't know where I was." So anyway, yeah, that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. I don't know if this is going to work, but I'm going to film a little bit of the dirt road heading down to Big Caliente and Little Caliente Hot Springs, and hopefully this won't be too boring of a segment here. I just wanted to give you some idea on what the road looks like, and let's keep filming until we get down here a little ways to the turn. It's pretty awesome. Well, we just passed the first low water stream crossing at the bottom of the dirt road, and now we are on Camusa Road, and we're getting ready to head to Big Caliente and Little Caliente. As you can see to the sign here, you make a right turn on Forest Service Road 5N16. And if you scan over here a little bit, this is the ranger station at this location.